Is this the most beautiful place in the Philippines? You decide as we take you on the most popular day out here in CORON, the Super Ultimate Tour. People have talked about this excursion continuously through the last 3 weeks we've been in Palawan, so our expectations are high and excitement through the roof as we start the day. Hit subscribe and let's explore the beauty of the Philippines together.
So we are waiting for our pickup in the hotel. The lady was like, you've got enough time to grab breakfast. So we just ordered. And the guy obviously comes running in, just our luck. Jackson party, ready to go. Now he's going to come back and get us at the end, which is really kind of him.
Eggplant, fried around egg. The egg is super crispy, so it tastes like a pancake.
Oh, that's good.
It does taste really nice.
Our transfer is here now. We've been waiting, anticipating the moment that our tour begins.
For the Super Ultimate Tour, which is marketing at its finest.
What a name.
Yeah.
Let's be bloody good. I don't get what we're doing.
I don't know either.
We're off the minibus, and now we need to find our tour guide. Very busy around here, though, where all the tour starts at the moment.
Thank you.
Absolute madness. So it's 3,400 for two people. We got a group photo.
Yeah, we got a group photo and now we're heading onto the boat. Looks like a nice group. It's not like a hostel one this time, so it's more like different groups, probably an older age group compared to the one that we did in El Nido, but it's gonna be a fun day.
Meet people first.
You're a big person too, yeah.
Apparently I am high. And we were off, or so we thought.
Apparently the oil is falling out of the engine of the boat, so we have to swap to another boat. God knows how long that's gonna take.
Cheers, bro.
So we're now on our new boat. We're all excited, and we are ready to roll on this tour. It's been a slight delay, but it's still only 9:30 in the morning, so we've got plenty of time to explore.
All you can say is, wow. First stop is Kainan Lake. Our little delay this morning means we have not beat the crowds. It is quite busy with boats, but it doesn't take away from the epic scenery that we've just pulled into with the limestone cliffs. Kainan Lake. Hello.
I don't know if I'm ready for more steps after bloody yesterday's hike up to CORON viewpoint, but we move, Abby, don't we?
Yeah.
We move. Behind me is the line for the photo opportunity that looks out obviously onto the mountains and the bay. As much as I'd like to get a good photo, our guide, God, I'm out of breath off the stairs. Our guide said you can sometimes have to wait like 20, 30 minutes and I can't be asked, I want to get in the water. Made it to Kainan Lake, which is a freshwater lake with a sprinkle of salt, and it's known for its underwater rock formations. And some say it is the cleanest lake in the whole of the Philippines, according to Google. Let's dive in. Oh, this is nice.
Is it nice and cold?
Yeah, it's like perfectly cold.
Sorry, go ahead.
It's like perfectly cold, crystal clear water. Cool, it's like big underwater mountains, or like big, I wouldn't say mountains, but like big underwater rock formations, yeah. It's actually pretty cool. It's like, not like coral, if you know what I mean. It's not like piece of coral, it's just like big jaggedy rocks.
So moving on to the next stop, which is only a 5 minute drive away apparently.
So next spot is Barracuda Lake, which is another obviously lagoon slash lake to swim in. The boat has to dock really far outside because the water's really shallow. So we've essentially got to swim to the entrance now. So yeah, wish us luck. Pretty epic walk down to the lake actually, look at this. Pretty vibey.
It's a mission in itself to get there, isn't it?
Yeah.
You do a vlog?
Yeah, YouTube.
Really?
Yeah.
You can shout out, guys, my YouTube channel, yeah, Palaboy Vlog.
Hey guys.
Well, you have a YouTube channel as well.
Yeah, I have a YouTube channel, but I can't start it now. Maybe soon, if I have a camera.
Yeah.
Yeah. My vlog is Palaboy vlog.
Palaboy?
You know Palaboy?
No.
It's a Palawan boy.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
You have to show us.
Palawan boy.
So there is barracudas in Barracuda Lake.
Are there barracudas?
There are barracudas. You said there's barracudas, right?
Yes, there are barracuda lakes
there. Yeah, and then it's enclosed by really tall limestone cliffs, so it's really got a dramatic scenery. And then if you snorkel or scuba dive down, there's Eiffel Tower rock structures at the bottom as well, so that's what it's famous for.
Oh, so
was watching people free dive down, and then he did like a smoke ring, but with air. Honestly, just watching them and the scuba divers really deep in the water was really cool.
Usually you don't know how deep it is because you can't see down, but the water is so crystal clear that you literally see how deep it is and see the rocks at the bottom, and you're like, shit, it's so deep. But yeah, another cool stop.
Dropped your hair as well, girls.
What?
You dropped your hair.
Jesus.
So we stopped at these little huts on stilts for lunchtime, which is really cool, and then you get a big lookout into the bay, which is stunning. The tree houses in the water are what's really unusual here, and I'm starving.
Lunch is served. Traditional Filipino food without soy sauce for me. As we ate, I couldn't help but think how beautiful it must be to live here. Coron Island itself is actually home to the indigenous Tagbanua people, possible descendants of the original inhabitants of the Philippines. They steward the land and sea and control access to the island, much of which is off limits to visitors. This is why there is very few accommodations on Coron Island, and visits need to be through an organised tour.
The lunch spot also doubles as our next snorkeling spot, which is called Coral Garden, which essentially is like a coral ridge with a load of clams stuck to the side of it. I want to know why it's not called Clam Garden. Vibey little hut here, so we can just chill around here for the next hour or so. Thoroughly enjoying this tour, actually.
Yeah, relaxing.
Got a good pace, good relaxing pace.
She was letting, like, up the...
Next stop is Twin Lagoon, which is famous for a little tunnel that you can swim in between the two lagoons.
The tunnel is open.
And it's not always open because of the tide. So if it's like too obviously high tide, then you have to free dive under, and they don't let people unless you're experienced do that. But we're in luck because it's open. Not much of a snorkel here, but we're going to get properly
in.
Yeah,
it's so deep, you can't see fish.
Yeah, so we're just going to like just float around, check out the
Are you going to dive for it?
Oh, I might dive for it actually. Could dive for it.
These may not be the most cinematic shots, but we spent our time here chatting to our new friends and taking in the epic scenery. Our favourite part about travel is getting to know new people from all around the world. This is what truly gives us life, and this tour was another day filled with amazing people.
We timed it well, now we're back on the boat and it is starting to rain, but it is rainy season.
So we were just driving off, and as we were driving off, people were like, are we missing two people on the boat? And everyone was like, yeah. And they were like, oh no, we're going to drive and go get them. But now we're driving around and no one can find where they are. So
they're in a green kayak, I think.
They're in a green, oh, they're in a kayak.
Yeah, they're in a kayak.
Okay,
they're in a kayak.
That one kayak, we're searching the other one kayak.
This is the start of a Netflix documentary. A Netflix documentary called The Green Kayak.
It's going out on his green kayak to find the other green kayak.
No.
The tunnel.
Hello.
There is a shipwreck in the distance. There's been a few shipwrecks these past few weeks. Gaz has decided to swim to it. I just want to have a bit of a chill. And to be honest, there's loads of stops in this tour. Like, it's actually loads to do.
What is it like, Gaz?
Yeah, good, but very deep. The shipwreck's quite deep here, isn't it?
It's like 5 meters deep.
Yeah, so you can't, it wasn't as close as the one on the island, but you could see it, but it was a little bit cloudy, but yeah, it was good. Lots of fishes swimming around it as well.
So a lady on the tour from the Philippines said that these guys who come around selling crisps and drinks is like the Philippines floating markets like they have in Thailand. So I thought that was quite funny. These are the best crisps. Taste it.
The last stop of the day is called CYC Beach, which our captain kindly informed us is a beach dedicated to CORON's young people. So loads of people get the boat over from CORON town and just chill here. But there's two beaches here. The first one is for people like us, i.e.
Annoying tourists.
So we come to one side of the beach on our tours, and then the other side of the beach is for locals, where apparently people come for birthday parties, hang out, have barbecues, and avoid the tourists, essentially.
As we soaked up the last half an hour of our tour, we reminisced on how great Palawan has been for our first location in the Philippines. A true beauty full of some of the most amazing beaches in the world, but the real beauty has come from the locals who have shown us their island and what it means to be Filipino. A happy, bubbly, laid-back culture full of karaoke, cheeky jokes, and a true desire to help others. This is why people love the Philippines and why you should visit if you ever have the opportunity. Thanks, Palawan, for the memories. Next stop is Cebu for an adventure-packed month. Hit subscribe and let's explore the Philippines like never before.